Hello and welcome to ASL Chennai Speaks Out Season 2. I'm Sanjay Pinto. If you sit anywhere in the city for a whole day and beg, you will get at least about 1,000 rupees. And you are giving a pittance of 1,000 rupees a month to people who defended the borders, to a person who safeguarded the country at a high altitude and whose arm had to be amputated. It is unfortunate that this is the way we treat our brave soldiers. We are treating them worse than beggars. Not my words, but the words of the Honorable Supreme Court recently in a case filed by, in fact, C.S. Sidhu, a short service commissioned officer who had to really wage a relentless battle to get his due. An 82-year-old freedom fighter, S.J. Chugani, for more than 6 decades after independence, had to again fight another battle for his pension. And in one of his last letters to the government, he wrote, "We were better under the British." A former army, a late army Nayak, Pratap Singh's wife Ganga Devi, had to fight for 56 years to get pension. A nation, ladies and gentlemen, that does not suitably honor its national heroes dishonors itself. And that's our proposition today on ASL Chennai Speaks Out. Do we truly remember and respect our national heroes? Panel today, Dr. Bernard D. Sami, Professor of History of Loyola College. Lalita Kumaramangalam, who is a member of the National Executive of the Bharatiya Janata Party, also the National Vice President of the Mahila Morcha. Both Dr. Bernard D. Sami and Mrs. Lalita Kumaramangalam believe that yes, we do respect and remember our national heroes. On the other side of the motion, Mr. Subha Rao, who is a trustee of the Golapudi Srinivas Memorial Foundation. And Colonel Hariharan, who was the former head of military intelligence of the Indian Peacekeeping Force. Both of them, in fact, Mr. Subha Rao and Colonel Hariharan believe that, yes, we do not respect or remember our national heroes. We also have a 95-year-old gentleman from the Indian National Army, from the INA, who's seated there. And students, professionals, people who really matter, the pulse of India, as we would like to call it. So first off the block is our initial round. It's called Opening Spell, where one of the team members get to make their introductory remarks, starting with Team 1.
First off, I'd like to say that, of course, we remember our heroes and we respect them. Look at recently, the increase in the popularity of what is today called Gandhigiri. About 5 or 10 years ago, there was this huge row on national TV when Ashok Rao Kavi from Bombay said something about Gandhi, and the whole that entire program had to be shelved because there was such a huge outcry from Indians across the country. It was nothing to do with being in Bombay or out of Bombay or Maharashtrian versus whatever other state that currently they are having problems with. Everybody just got up and protested and said, you cannot make such statements about Gandhi, whatever may be your personal beliefs. Secondly, look at how we've almost deified B.R. Ambedkar. The man deserves an enormous amount of praise. He was the architect of our constitution. Apart from that, he was many things. He was poet, philosopher, economist, lawyer. Maybe all of this we don't know in detail. But look at how we've almost deified him. Remember, Ambedkar may have been a very educated man, but he was a Dalit. For a Dalit to break all barriers in a country like ours, which is still riddled by the caste system, unfortunately, this shows that we still admire and respect our heroes. I'm just giving you very small bullet points because I have only 2 minutes. Now, I see a lot of people from the younger generation here, and admittedly, especially last night when I was sitting and talking to my daughter's friends, they said that we celebrate the heroes who are relevant to our life today, who reflect our values, our needs. Look at how today we have picked up ordinary people from across the country, whether they are what they call citizen journalists on some TV channels, whether they are people who save other people's lives in various ways, from drowning, from bullets, from terrorists, etc. We are celebrating them. We're giving them bravery awards. We're not sticking to just the big business people and the ones who are always in the news. These are unsung, unheard of heroes, but today they are no longer unsung or unheard. Thirdly, what do we remember? Fourthly, remember Rabindranath Tagore for? Not for his sorry, not for his contribution to the Indian independence movement, but for the fact that he wrote our national anthem. The fact that we still agreed, admittedly, sometimes we lose focus and we don't always only talk about our freedom fighters who were heroes, etc. We have become more rooted in the present, but then that's the way life is. People moves on, life moves on. But along with that, I don't think we have forgotten our heroes and our heroines. We do celebrate them, we do respect them.
All right, thank you very much, ma'am. Short and sweet, team two.
Now, respected madam, she referred to Gandhigiri in 21st century. I have a simple question. 30th January is supposed to be called, it is remembered as Martyrs' Day, where Mahatma Gandhi was killed. The expected gesture from everybody in India is that at 11 o'clock in the morning, you are expected to observe 1 minute silence. Whatever you do, you just cease your activities and do. But I haven't. Today I've been living in this city for the last, for that matter, I've traveled all over the country, but nowhere, people don't even remember that the 30th January as a Martyrs' Day. It is, for Christ's sake, he is supposed to be the father of the nation. It's a simple thing. In any Western country, if you go, Sanjay, I mean, this would have been a law. This would have been, and then anybody breaking the law would be jailed or would be put to task. But then I don't want any law here. This is a kind of a gesture which is supposed to come from, it should be spontaneous. But sadly, I don't think anybody remembers, and that is a sad way of remembering your father of the nation. There's another small example. We have a culture here in this country where it says that any prominent person living in a particular locality, you name that street after that particular person. There is a street in T Nagar which is called, which used to be called Bogue Road. Then it was called Dr. B. N. Reddy Road. Dr. B. N. Reddy was a famous personality of the celluloid, and he was decorated with Padma Bhushan. It's fine, it's good. Then suddenly one politician decided that no, we should remove the Reddy in that name is something signifying some caste. So let us remove that. So it was called BN Road. After some time, another politician decided, no, we should not call it BN Road. We'll only call it Narsimhan Road. Now today, even if Dr. BN Reddy's grandchildren, even they wouldn't know that Narsimhan actually refers to their grandfather. This is a sorry state where we can't even remember a prominent person who lived in your locality. We can't even have their full name. Is this the way we remember our national heroes? Or this is not even a national hero, this is a man who lived in your locality and then who served the society there. So I think we don't remember our national heroes. We don't even have that concept. Neither is it spontaneous, nor do we even have any respect towards them.
All right. Thank you very much for your opening remarks. Talking of Martyrs' Day, I know that in several parts of Chennai, it's an occasion for Tasmac shops to sell booze on the slide.